Hello, Swan Student. How are you all? And I hope you are doing well. Welcome to St. Mary British National High School online classes. Today, we are going to be looking at a topic in our commerce class, which is what? Business organization. What is business organization? If I may ask, business organizations, these are different forms of business owned by private individuals or corporate works, organizations. For example, St. Mary British National School is a good example of what? A business organization owned by the MU Asakole. Then we also have other conglomerates, like Provisional Conglomerates, owned by John Adu. Then we also have World of Faith Group of School. Then we have other businesses around our state. But today we are going to take one particular one, which is what? The sobrietorship. But first and foremost, let me tell you that business organization is divided into two. We have one, the sole proprietorship, the partnership, and the what? The corporate bodies. When we say the sole proprietorship, this is owned by what? An individual. Then now the partnership is owned from 2 to 50 members as what? As they come together to form what? A business. Now the third one is limited liability companies. But today we are going to be looking at what? A sole proprietorship business. So who is a sole proprietorship? Yes, a sole proprietorship is a business owned by one individual who provides all capital, takes the risk, all the profit as well. Yes, I talked about the school, for example, owned by Lady M.E. Ward as Saturday. You understand me? She's the owner of the school. She takes the profit and she also bears the risk. The situation whereby the business is not growing well, she has nobody to hold responsible for that. Instead, she really wants to face it. You see it now? Then also, they also take all the capital and the so-called proprietorship business. Then a good example is that aboki in your house, maybe at the junction of your house. You understand? That one I used to say, maybe send me another provision. You understand? That one another good example of what? A sole-proprietorship business. Then let's see ownership. Let's see features or characteristics. When we say features, characteristics, attributes, they are all the same thing. It means the same thing. Then one of the features, how do you know a sole-proprietorship business? Ownership is owned by what? By an individual. You see now, I talked about the school, for example. Owned by the owner is owned by the anyone as a company. See? So that's one of the features of a sole proprietorship business. That is how you know what a sole proprietorship business. Another one again is that's one of the features of the company. Then source of capital. How do sole proprietorship? Then let's look at the future characteristics of a sole proprietorship business. Yes, as you can see, I have a diagram here. This is a very perfect good example of what a sole proprietorship business. You see, there is a seller and also what a buyer. And this happened to be a provision shop that sells all varieties of what? Goods. These are the very good example of what a sole proprietorship business. It's owned by what? By private what? Individual. That's how you know what a sole proprietorship business. And also the mention of our school, for example, owned by the MBA Sacramento. It's also what a sole proprietorship business. Then also we can also talk about, let's say, like those that have small business around, like the aboki that stays in your junction, maybe in your house or in your yard, maybe selling indomie, all those provisions, items, you understand? So this can also be what? A sole proprietorship for business owned by what? Private individual. Then let's look at source of capital. When we say source of capital, speak about how they generate their money to start such businesses. You understand me? Then one is what? It comes from the capital used in running a business comes from the proprietor. Yes, the proprietor gets the capital either through his personal savings or through loans or through family help. You understand me? Then motive. His aim is to provide self-employment and to make profits. That is motive of what? Operating this the business. That is people that work under him or her. Like for example, now in our school year, we have teachers, we have management staff that work under the school proprietors. You understand me? By so doing, employment, she has created employment. At the same time, she also made profit for her own self. So these are one of the motive of what? Over the sole proprietorship. Then we have the legal status. The legal status have talked about the law. In sole proprietorship business, law does not bind them. As in, it does not look like that of a cooperative society, a cooperative establishment. Whereby there are processes that one needs to follow. No. Maybe for example now, maybe at the end of the week you go out of your house. You find out that you just want to start selling that the junction of your house that was not there yesterday. So it's very, very easy to form. Like when you talk about establishments that are well recognized by the law, they pass through processes. What is but that is a partnership organization or business, does not follow such procedures. Then we have source of capital, it's a personal savings. Yes, the sole proprietorship can get his or her own money to start business through what? Personal savings. Then we also have grants from relations. Maybe relations can be those types that have money, that are influential. Understand me? I've seen a situation where my son is thinking of how to start business and there's no money. She now went to go and meet one of his uncle. Understand me? He was going to give her money to start. And today, she has room to repay that money back. See? So we also have loans from friends. Sometimes you have good friends that are that have money, understand me? Those who net friends, understand me, they can also help you, understand? Then loans from the bank also give loans, understand? It can be from a short-term loans or a long-term loans. The short one have to do with a situation of 6 months, while the long one have to do with a situation of a year or 2 years, depending on the collateral you are dropping. Then we also have loans from government. Yes, the government also help. It also gives loans, especially those that work in government establishments. Understand? Then federal government, same thing. Then states and local governments. I think those who are benefits from the government, federal government, and local government are those who that really work under these parastatals. Yeah, thank you very much. Have a nice day. I'll see you in my next class. And make sure you do your assignment.